Clinton Township Planning Commission meeting for February 9, 2023 to order, starting with Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Mr. Sasson, will you take roll call, please?
Absolutely. Commissioner Kurd?
Yes.
Commissioner DeBartolomeo?
Here.
Commissioner Harris is excused. Commissioner Hubler?
Here.
Commissioner Jansen?
Here.
Trustee Patton?
Here.
Sasson here, and Commissioner Wade?
Here.
And I think Green?
Commissioner Green is excused.
Thank you. And also in attendance, our planning director, Mr. Bruce Thompson. Next is the approval of the agenda. The petitioner's not here right now. One thing we have on the agenda tonight, but what I thought is that we can go through the other parts of the agenda and then see if he comes back. So I'll make that addendum to it, and if I can get a motion for that.
So moved.
Kurd supports.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. So we'll start with public comment. Mr. Bouchelle, good evening. How are you tonight?
Very good. How about yourself?
Nice to see you. So what's on the agenda for you tonight?
Well, as you know, last Saturday I sent you all copies of letters by the Commission and the Planning Department recommending approval of site plans, attesting that they met all zoning requirements when they did not meet minimum requirements. I sent this to you last week to allow you to correct these misstatements and hopefully stop sending substandard recommendations in the future. In the case of the standalone gravel storage lot on Grosbeck, it is a new low for site plan properties in Clinton Township, which my FOIA approved. The planner informed you all that required screen walls must be masonry, but the Board of Trustees can approve whatever they want. That being said, why would you or the Planning Department send recommendations assuring the board the project meets all requirements? Another major issue is making sure the citizens are aware of proposed zoning changes in properties under site plan revisions in their neighborhood. As was made clear at both your January meetings, the required notices did not make it to the affected property owners. Signs advertising the appearance before planning or zoning board appeals should be posted on all properties. This is done in many of our nearby communities, and I ask that you recommend this policy to the Board of Trustees. It does not matter if the notices did not make it due to planning department or post office error. We do not need the blame game, only a very easy fix. Please post the signs. We have Trustee Commissioner Patton here, and hopefully you would ask her to take this to the Board of Trustees to try to get these signs put in place. Thank you. That's it.
Thank you very much, Mr. Michelle. Anybody else for public comment? I'm going to assume the people that walked in, you're on the agenda tonight.
Yes.
Okay, so we'll go back to that, if that's okay with the commissioners, and then we can come back with with reporting. Okay, so item number one, 2.5 acres fronting the south side of Cass Avenue, east of Romeo Plank Road. This is site development plan approval for proposed addition to Partridge Creek Plaza. This is request for approval. Petitioner is Justin Kallo. Petitioner present, would you like to step up, please, and state your name and address?
Yeah, Justin Kallo. You want the business address?
Yes, please.
18970 Cass Avenue.
Thank you. Mr. Thompson?
Thank you. If I can call everybody's attention to the screen. Again, this is the plaza that's on the south side of Cass, just east of Romeo Plank. They are looking at constructing a small addition to the west end of the site. So in this case, Cass Avenue is at the bottom of the picture. So north is at the bottom of the picture. And I think this is even more exciting, certainly if they have the ability to provide more leasable space, we want them to be able to do that. It makes it more successful for everybody. But it's what they're going to do to the exterior of the structure that's going to be really make a big difference in this area. And I think it's going to really raise the bar in this particular area so that we can look at it and say, how do you want redevelopments to look? We want them to look like this.
Yeah.
They come to you with both of those things. Back to the site plan, you'll see the site has little to no landscaping at this point. So they are providing landscaping, parking lot interior and street side. They're as well creating new dumpster enclosures at the rear of the property. The parking on that site will remain. It's actually in excess of ordinance requirements based on square footage. The driveways will remain. Wall pack lighting will be updated, obviously, when you update the exterior of the building. But otherwise, the site stays predominantly the same. As such, we are recommending that you forward this to the Township Board with a recommendation for approval.
Thank you. Anything you'd like to add?
No, I'm good.
You good?
Yeah, I've been there for like 15 years right. at the convenience store.
Yep.
And we finally got a hold of purchasing the property, and we're just excited. And we're just
so you own the liquor store?
I own the liquor store at the end, yeah. And we're just excited because
somewhere before.
What is it?
That's where I've seen you before.
Yeah. And I just know there's potential there, and we're excited to get it done, you know?
Good. Thank you.
Yep.
It's not a public hearing. Has anybody got a comment? Nothing? Turn it over to the commissioners. Anybody have questions or comments? Go ahead.
I had a question about the lighting on the site. I actually just stopped in and grabbed a drink before I came into the meeting. Seems there's on the party store side, there's lots of lighting. There are a lot of extra lights on the exterior of the building and more on the pole.
Yeah.
It seems much darker down to the other end.
Yeah.
And I note that in the letter from the planner, he says site lighting will not be altered.
Yeah.
So I guess question to Bruce, existing poles as the external lighting stands, that's within spec?
That's perfectly acceptable. It's their parking lot. Our ordinance doesn't say you have to have X amount of lights for a parking lot. It only basically says that it has to be downcast.
Downcast.
Yep. Right.
Okay.
And then obviously if you look at this plan as well, you'll see new accent wall lighting throughout the exterior of that building should help kind of even things out in that respect as well.
Yeah, the reason why I did that is because when I didn't own the building, the landlord didn't want to put money into the property.
Mm-hmm.
So I went out of pocket and did that.
Okay.
So I plan on lighting it all up when I'm done with it, hopefully, you know. But there's, once I'm done with it, I'm going to light it a little bit more. You just need one light on the poles. I just added an extra light.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and that's what I noticed. On your side of the building, plenty of light, easy to park.
I'm shocked you noticed that. A lot of people don't notice that.
And then I was pulling out at the far end where the new construction will go.
Yeah.
And some kids were riding by their bikes. I'm like,
So
is this drawing representative of kind of like you'll have accent lights all the way down, so at late at night it would be
It's going to be all it's going to be evened out.
Okay.
Yep.
All right. Awesome. Thank you.
It's going to be evened out. Yep.
Are you going to stay where you're at, or are you going to move down to the other end where it's bigger space?
No, I actually just remodeled it like 2 years ago. I put like a lot of money into it, and it's going to be too expensive to move it. Everything costs a lot of money right now. Yeah. So
are you going to add on at the very end, like 1,800 square feet, I think?
A lot of people are calling me. I don't want to make no moves until I'm done with the remodeling.
Okay.
Just to get a better feel of things.
Okay. So you don't have any tenants lined up to come in or anything?
Not yet. No, I'm not really looking for. I want it done remodeled, and so I can figure out the cost of the remodeling to know what to charge for rent.
Okay.
Yep.
Right. How long do you think the remodeling is going to take you?
To be honest with you, I don't know. Hopefully, it gets done within 3 months.
Do you have a company lined up and everything right now?
I'm dealing with quotes right now with two contractors.
Okay.
Yep. Hopefully, 3 months. If not, maybe max 6 months. They take their time sometimes, can't control them. That's they're kind of like, yeah.
Be a big improvement.
Huge.
Further questions, comments, motion?
I'll make a motion for approval for the proposed addition to Partridge Creek Plaza.
I'll second it.
Thank you. Roll call.
Is that Mr. Wade?
Yeah. Bruce.
Trustee Patton?
Yes.
What's the date?
Commissioner Wade?
Yes.
Commissioner Curd?
Yes.
Commissioner DiBartolomeo?
Yes.
Commissioner Harris is excused. Commissioner Green is excused. Commissioner Hubler?
Yes.
Commissioner Jansen?
Yes.
And Commissioner Sasson? Yes.
Motion passes. So we're a recommending body. So you will be on the agenda in front of the Board of Trustees on Monday, February 27th for final approval.
Okay.
Good luck to you.
All right, thank you.
Love what we're seeing. Thank you.
Mr. DiBartolomeo, there was 309 notifications sent out and
good.
None returned.
Thank you for reminding me. Appreciate it. Thank you.
All right. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Okay, so we'll jump down then to report of the meeting from January 26, 2023. I'm assuming everyone's had a chance to look at it. Are there any additions or corrections to be made at this time? Hearing none, is there a motion?
So moved.
Support.
All All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Discussion of the next meeting.
Okay, so at the next meeting, we'll have two items. One is Consumers Energy at 15 and Kelly. I met with those folks after their last meeting, as you had asked. They contacted me, and we sat down. And they've come forward with a revised plan, hopefully to address your concerns. So we'll get that one out to you.
Awesome.
The other is special land use and site development plan approval for the gas station that is at Hayes and 17, southeast corner. It's one of the few kind of small kiosky type gas stations that we have left in the township, although Kroger's building one. So I guess, you know, those things continue on. But, you know, we've had a couple of gas stations recently change hands, and they're looking at redeveloping the site. This is one of them.
Nice.
This will be a fairly large building. It's a pretty big site, and they want to put a drive-through in, not unlike the one you just recently saw, just to have the ability to do drive-through for likely a restaurant or a carryout only that would be within the building. They don't have a Starbucks or a Dunkin'. It's not something along those lines where it's a national chain type of drive-through. I think those are kind of getting pretty common with these C-store owners as they start providing their own food. They start creating their own kitchen and food and give people the ability to drive through and pick it up versus just coming into a C-store.
And what
so.
Corner is that?
Southeast 17 and Hayes.
Wasn't that at one time going to be a development, an apartment development? Remember?
No, that's a little bit farther south.
With La Llama?
Yeah, that one's a little farther south. At, okay. What's the next? Is it Utica?
Okay.
Just south of there?
All right.
So okay. that's at the northeast corner of Utica.
Yeah. Okay.
And Hayes,
yeah.
the one you're talking about. Because
right.
that one came kind of finished up just when I got here.
Gotcha.
It was a conditional rezoning.
Right. Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. Okay.
Yeah. So those are the two things we've got. One other thing, if you don't mind, Mr. Chairman, I'd like to mention. We finally, through many iterations and a lot of discussion and that, have a draft zoning code ready to go.
Okay.
We are planning on holding the public hearing at the March 23rd meeting here,
okay.
at the Planning Commission. We'll be getting the zoning code draft online. And then we'll obviously post notice in the paper, as we're required to do. It'll be both for the text and a change to the map, because you are being asked to consider creating the growth spec overlay district from the growth spec guidelines that were approved as part of that growth spec plan. So that would require a change to the map as well, and that would be consistent with that growth spec corridor master plan designation. We're going to give everybody good amount of time. Will be obviously it'll be accessible to you, obviously the township board, to the public, even the ZBA. I want them to take a look at it as well. Not that they have a public hearing or anything, but
right.
you know, we want to involve them because they make decisions based on zoning code issues and that kind of thing. Once the public hearing is held, from a process standpoint, we are required to notify the county commission and give them 30 days. To review it and comment back. If they do or when they do, you know, whatever the case may be, it is scheduled to the township board for their consideration. Okay. So in essence, that's the process for you. So I'll send you guys an email and let you know when we've got that available online for viewing. It's too big for me to email to you, so that's not gonna happen. But certainly take your time. There's a lot of good changes. I'll include a summary letter from the consultant. And obviously at that public hearing meeting, the consultant will be here as well to give you her kind of overview of what changes were made, what recommendations came from the committee that we put together, the internal committee. There'll be some really good changes. There'll be some drastic changes in some cases, but some that are needed. I also want you to think about this too, is that it's a pretty big document, right? There's a lot of changes being made. And we want to make sure the changes are correct, and the attorney's there for that, right? There, he's going to review it too, and he has to make sure that everything is, for all intents and purposes, defensible, right? That it meets the statutes and it follows the zoning enabling legislation, those kinds of things.
Mm-hmm.
When you take a document this big and then you start implementing it, it's likely we're going to see some of the changes may not be what we want them to be. And so I want you to kind of keep in mind that maybe about a year or so in, we may want to take a quick little look at it and say, you know, that's not working. Maybe we ought to do this and change, you know. So I don't want to say it's a fluid document, but I think in application of what will likely be some of the new standards, we may find that they work or they don't work. And, you know, so I just want to kind of keep that in mind, because there's no way that any one person, I've read through the document many, many times, and I can't sit here and tell you every little aspect of it and apply every aspect of it to potential situations out there as we progress forward. But just something to think about, right? Let's get this process finished up and then keep on moving on.
All right.
Okay? Just want to make you aware.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Any other questions or comments by the commissioners? Hearing none, is there a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Meeting adjourned. Thank you.